Hello and welcome to another racket review. Today I'm going to review the new Headgraphene 360 Plus Extreme Tour. Finally, the Extreme Tour is here. It's the racket I have been waiting for a very long time. It's the brand new Headgraphene 360 Extreme Tour. It's basically a version of the Babolat Pure Aero VS, but it's Head's idea. It's the same specs, the same category, and the same performance, except the Head Tour doesn't have a aero beam as the Babolat does. This new racket from Head is updated with the Graphene 360 Plus instead of the Graphene 360. It means it has spiral fibers to improve feel, but it also has a completely new mold. So that's why it's a new edition in the Extreme line. It has not existed in the past and is now going to compete with the Babolat rackets. So the racket I got from Head is blacked out, so it's not the original paint. It won't be black as in the video. On the screen you can see a picture. It will be gray and yellow. I think it looks pretty good. The Extreme line is made for players wanting extreme power and spin and therefore uses it to dominate the match. But in this case, the Extreme Tour is not a extreme racket. I would say it's more a controlled racket. It's not the extreme power and spin that you will get with the original Extreme MP or the Extreme Pro. So this Tour version is between a Extreme and a Head Radical in terms of playability and feel. The specs almost matches a Radical. It's a little bit lower in weight compared to the Radical Pro, but the feel, power and spin are more like an Extreme racket. So here you can see the racket specifications. It has a 98 square inch head, standard length, 305 grams unstrung weight. The balance is 350 millimeters. It does have a 16x19 string pattern, but it's way tighter compared to the normal Extreme, which has very wide mains, but this Tour version has very narrow mains. The beam width is 22, 23, 21 millimeters all through. It has a stiffness rating of 65 RA, which is pretty standard. It's not too high, not too low. It's almost like the previous Extreme rackets. And the power level is on a 500 CPI, which is the Head power scale. It's not more power than a Radical racket, but it's definitely lower than a Speed MP. So it's in between. From start, I really enjoyed playing with this racket, and I'm actually considering into making the switch from my Dunlop CX200 Tour, because it's really just a great racket. But the question is it an extreme racket? It's hard for me to answer that question because I actually don't know. It kind of feels like an extreme racket, but at the same time it doesn't play the same, which is the meaning of this racket. But calling it an extreme, I don't know. Babolat have done the exactly same thing as Head with their Pure Aero VS, which they made from the original Pure Aero and they made it to a more controlled frame. The Pure Aero VS and the Extreme Tour are basically the same racket as I said, but they feel very different. The Extreme Tour has a more disconnected feel on impact, while the Pure Aero VS has better feel but more shock absorption. And also you need to get used to the aero beam on the Pure Aero. So all in all, it's a very spin friendly racket despite having a tight 16x19 string pattern. It delivers precision and control that a normal Extreme just won't deliver as a racket. So that meaning I had no problems going for my targets. One issue I had was on short low balls where I just wanted to gently drop the ball back over and I didn't hit the sweet spot perfectly. I got no pop and no lift on the ball. It simply just died right on the string bed and went straight into the net. The same thing happened on ground strokes when I didn't come under the ball, creating much spin on the ball. The ball wouldn't lift up and it just went flat right into the net. This racket still handles flat balls pretty decent, since I use both topspin and flat sometimes, and I had no problems using this racket. Compared to the Extreme, it doesn't create as much spin, but it handles different types of strokes better. I tested this racket with two different string setups, one full bed of Headlings Tour and another with Links Tour in the mains and Headsonic Pro in the crosses, both at 24 kilos or 55 pounds. I played well in all areas of the court and especially on mid to high level attacking shots when I approached the net. There wasn't any balls coming back afterwards, and that connection made me think it handled those shots pretty good. So let's say if you used an older Extreme racket and it just wasn't a match for you, you didn't like it, you thought it was just flying too long because you didn't use enough topspin or whatever it was, give this racket a shot because it's pretty much a controlled version of the Extreme MP and it handles flat balls much better. But it's still not a completely controlled racket, it's not a radical, it's still an racket towards the Extreme path. It's more of a twin racket that will fit a lot of players. So that is all for this review. If you want me to do an in-depth review or comparison of the Head Extreme Tour and the Babolat Pure Aero VS, or any other comparison, please comment. And comment if you have any other questions. And don't forget to check out my Instagram, Tennis Rally. And that will be all. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next review. Bye.